helps the voiceless creature. Hello everyone, welcome to my channel, The Vet Tutorial. In this video, I am going to explain some of the economic traits with the help of graph. In this graph, suppose the cow's birth at this point, and we also know that after the cow birth, we also measure the weight of the newborn calf, which is known as birth weight. And after few weeks or few months, it basically depends upon the animals. The smaller size animal has less estrus as compared to larger animals. So let's take the example of cow. Age at first estrus, that is AFE, comes approximately at 11 months. Age at first estrus is also known as age at puberty. And at that time, if the age at first fertile surface, that is AFFS, occur, which means first successful conception occur, then gestation period starts. And the gestation period of a cow is 9 months 9 days, that is approximately 280 days, and in buffaloes 10 months 10 days, that is approximately is 310 days. Then after the completion of gestation period, first calving occurs. Then after that, lactation period starts, or the lactation yield starts. Then at the middle of the lactation period, the highest daily yield in kg occurs, that is known as peak yield. As we can see in this graph, first the milk yield increases and continuously decreases. Here the persistency is very low. Suppose if the graph is like this, here it is peak yield, and if the peak yield persist or maintain for a longer period, which is known as persistency. And as I already told in my previous video, that high persistency is necessary to maintain high level of milk production. Suppose at this point cow gives 2 liter, 4 liter, 5 liter, and it increase up to 10 liter, and it continues till this point, which is approximately suppose 4 days. So this consistency of 10 liter milk up to 4 days is known as persistency. And then after the completion of lactation period, then dry period starts. And after the dry period, second calving starts. From this point to this point, service period occur, and at this point, age at second fertile service occur, which means second successful conception occur. Then after this, gestation period starts. So this is service period and this is gestation period, or the lactation period plus dry period. This whole is known as intercalving period. As I already told in the previous video, that intercalving period is service period plus gestation period, or lactation period plus dry period. And also, age at first fertile service plus gestation period is known as age at first calving. Service period of a cow is approximately 120 days. And the dry period is approximately 60 days. Suppose we have to find the lactation period. So in a year, there is 365 days. And if we subtract dry period, that is 60 days, then 305 days comes. So lactation period is total of 305 days approximately. This period or this region is more energy consuming for the cow, as she has to do more work in this region. First, she has to do lactation, then second, maintenance for pregnancy, then its own maintenance. Here we end the explanation of some of the economic traits with graphical representation. Hope you understand it well. Stay safe and let's meet in the next video.